Looking for hair removal tools that not only deliver smooth results, but also empower you with a sense of complete control? Enter Conair Girl Bomb, your secret weapons for smooth, sleek results, made just for women. From the ultimate Girl Bomb grip and professional-grade blades, you don't have to compromise and settle for less. Conair Girl Bomb equips you with the precision and power previously reserved for men's grooming tools. So take your hair removal routine to the next level with Conair Girl Bomb. Available at conairgirlbomb.com or a retailer near you.
Residents at Brightview Senior Living Communities enjoy enhanced possibilities, independence, and choice. Brightview Dulles Corner in Herndon and Brightview, Great Falls, offer vibrant senior independent living, assisted living, and memory care services through various daily programs and cultural events. Chef-prepared meals, safety and security, transportation, resort-style amenities, and high-quality care. Everything you need is here. Discover more at brightviewseniorliving.com. Equal housing opportunity.
This is your moment, your time to shine, your comeback. You're ready for the next step in your career, and you want an education employers respect. So you're not just going back to school. You're coming back with Purdue Global. Backed by Purdue University, one of the nation's most respected public universities, Purdue Global is built for people who bring their life experience into the online classroom. Purdue Global, Purdue's online university for working adults. Start your comeback today at purdueglobal.edu.
Let's clear out winter and clean up the lawn with spring Black Friday savings at the Home Depot. Right now, get the Ryobi One Plus leaf blower for just $89 and make your lawn work easier with a powerful 90 miles an hour of clearing power. And with convenient online shopping, you can order on the app, pick up in store, and get outside sooner. Get your yard spring ready with the Ryobi One Plus leaf blower, now just $89 during spring Black Friday at the Home Depot. How doers get more done.
Hello. From Wonder Media Network, I'm Jenny Kaplan, and this is Womanica. Historically, women have been told to make themselves smaller, to diminish themselves. Some have used that idea to their advantage, disappearing into new identities. For others, a disappearance was the end to their stories, but the beginning of a new chapter of their legacies. This month, we're telling the stories of these women. We're talking about disappearing acts. Today's Womanican began writing poems at 4 years old, constructed a 25-page nursery tale at five, and published her debut novel before she turned 13. No one could deny that she was a spectacular talent with a bright future ahead of her. But suddenly, at the age of 25, she disappeared without a trace. Let's talk about Barbara Newhall Follett. Barbara was born in Hanover, New Hampshire in 1914. Her father was a well-known literary critic who worked at Dartmouth, Brown, and Yale before becoming an editor at a popular publishing house in New York City. Barbara was homeschooled by her parents, who believed that she should feel free to explore her interests in whatever way she pleased. At just 4 years old, Barbara discovered her father's typewriter and was immediately entranced. She started writing her own stories, poems, and letters. From a young age, it was clear that she had a gift for writing that far surpassed her age. As her father noted, she was always seeing A's in the gables of houses and H's in football goalposts. By the age of six, Barbara had already written a 4,500-word children's story called The Life of the Spinning Wheel, The Rocking Horse, and the Rabbit. For most of her life, Barbara did not have close friends her age. So her writing often seemed to be an outlet to explore the imaginary characters and friendships that she lacked in reality. At the age of eight, Barbara began to describe her daydream world and even developed a language for it. She wrote poems in her newfound language and lavished in an imaginary world that was all her own. She wrote a beautifully long-winded description of the place to a friend. It read, "I want that green, fairy-like, woodsy, animal-filled, watery, luxuriant, butterfly-painted, moth-dotted, dragonfly-blotched, bird-filled, salamandrous, mossy, ferny, sunshiny, moonshiny, long-dayful, short-nightful land on that fish-froggy, tadpoley, shelly, lizard-filled lake. Oh, no end of lovely things to say about that place, and I am mad to get there." Tragically, in 1923, the Follett family house burned to the ground. Because of this, lots of Barbara's early work was lost. But Barbara, a persistent wordsmith, never stopped writing for very long. The following year, she began writing a manuscript that had been burned in the fire. It was the story of a young girl who ran away from home and went on to live a nomadic life. This became a full-length novel called The House Without Windows, which was eventually published by her father's publishing company in 1927. The book was an instant success. One review at the time declared, "These pages simply quiver with the beauty, happiness, and vigor of forests, seas, and mountains. I can safely promise joy to any reader of it, perfection." After her rise to fame, Barbara wanted more to write about. Barbara had developed a fascination with pirates, life at sea, and nature. So in 1927, Barbara joined a crew of sailors on a Nova Scotian lumber trading schooner and wrote about her adventures in a second book, The Voyage of the Normandy. It seemed that nothing could stop this young woman as she churned out new work. Until something did stop her. In 1928, Barbara's parents separated. Her father had become involved with a younger female employee at the publishing house and left the family to move in with this new lover. Barbara looked up to her father and cared about him very much, so his leaving hurt her deeply. In need of a break from it all, Barbara and her mother struck out on an adventure. They sailed from New York to Barbados with little more than a suitcase, two typewriters, and a small amount of money. On the journey, Barbara met and fell in love with a sailor named Edward Anderson, and their romance would become the inspiration for a central love story in her third book project titled Lost Island. Not even the novelty of this trip could boost her spirits. She was deep in despair and in desperate need of another writing gig. By 1929, she was back in the U.S. and had been taken in by family friends in Los Angeles, as she was still a teenager at this point. She was also enrolled at a junior college. But she was still unhappy and ran away to a hotel in San Francisco to write poetry by herself. After her disappearance was reported, the police tracked her down and she nearly threw herself out the hotel window before they could catch her. The press had a field day with the story. When Barbara returned to New York City, her financial situation was dire. The stock market had just crashed and the ensuing Great Depression made it difficult to find any work. She wrote about this time in letters explaining, "My dreams are going through their death flurries. I mean no particular dream, you understand, but the whole radiant flock of them together. They are dying before the steel javelins and arrows of a world of time and money." Luckily, in the early 1930s, Barbara made a few new friends, one of whom was a man named Nickerson Rogers. Barbara and Nick began adventuring together, hitchhiking all around the Northeast and traveling overseas in Europe. The two married in 1934, but life together as a couple was rocky. According to a friend, on December 7, 1939, Barbara got into a fight with Nick, and then she left the house. She was 25 years old at the time and was never seen again. Nick went to the police, but the missing persons bulletin used her married name. The press didn't pick up on this news story. In fact, the general public didn't even know she was missing until 1966, when Barbara's mother co-authored a book about her daughter. The exact end of Barbara's life still remains a mystery, but her literary voice lives on in her prose, poetry, and the many letters she wrote to friends over the course of her life. All month, we're talking about disappearing acts. For more information, find us on Facebook and Instagram at Womanica Podcast. Special thanks to Liz Kaplan, my favorite sister and co-creator. Talk to you tomorrow.
Residents at Brightview Senior Living Communities enjoy enhanced possibilities, independence, and choice. Brightview Dulles Corner in Herndon and Brightview, Great Falls, offer vibrant senior independent living, assisted living, and memory care services through various daily programs and cultural events. Chef-prepared meals, safety and security, transportation, resort-style amenities, and high-quality care. Everything you need is here. Discover more at brightviewseniorliving.com. Equal housing opportunity.
Looking for hair removal tools that not only deliver smooth results, but also empower you with a sense of complete control? Enter Conair Girl Bomb, your secret weapons for smooth, sleek results, made just for women. From the ultimate Girl Bomb grip and professional-grade blades, you don't have to compromise and settle for less. Conair Girl Bomb equips you with the precision and power previously reserved for men's grooming tools. So take your hair removal routine to the next level with Conair Girl Bomb. Available at ConairGirlBomb.com or a retailer near you.
Does money stress you out? Let Facet flip your financial chaos into clarity.
We feel way more confident and secure in our finances, and with that comes a sense of freedom.
Financial planning from Facet is here to help you improve your life today, tomorrow, and every day after that.
Facet was really the place where we saw all of the tools and the people coming together.
Visit Facet.com, F-A-C-E-T.com to learn more. This ad is sponsored by Facet. Facet Wealth is an SEC-registered investment advisor. This is not an offer to buy or sell securities, nor is it investment, legal, or tax advice. These testimonials are from current Facet members who are not compensated. All opinions are their own and not a guarantee of a similar outcome.
You deserve a moment to yourself every single day. And a delicious bite of a Keebler Sandies can give you that comforting pause. Take a pause from your to-do list with the melt-in-your-mouth magic of a Keebler Sandies. This magic is baked into simple shortbread cookies by Ernie and the Keebler Elves. So as life continues to fly by, make the most of your me moment. Take a pause and enjoy a Keebler Sandies.